Hey guys, it's your boy, we're back with more Mall Fishbite content, and today's video is all about artifacts. What are artifacts? What are the uses? Are there bad artifacts? Are there good artifacts? Which artifacts you should be going forward to and probably grinding them if you are not able to purchase them via the shop or crystal shop? Or artifacts, are they really useful to any certain characters? Or can they be equipped to any of the other characters? Whatever questions you have, because I know a lot of you guys might be overwhelmed because of all the information that has been spread out about artifacts, and they, I would say, have not been the clearest, I think, Netmarble from dev side. I think dev should have done a little bit better job at explaining certain things about the artifact, but once you get it, it's gonna be actually very, very easy to understand the artifacts. So, without further ado, let's dive right into what are basically artifacts. So you can see I played some time on survival. I got some of these 1-star artifacts. Sadly, I was not able to get the 2-star. 1-star, of course, are the most common. 2-star is a little bit rare. 3-star up to the 6-star are very, very, very rare unless you purchase them from the shop with the crystals, and you might not get it or you might get it. It's still a chance. Anyways, I got these 1-stars. Artifacts basically are the additional gears like Urus, CDPs, ISOs and everything that will enhance your character's basically instinct stats and also giving you some buffs along with that stat boost. Okay, first thing. Second thing, can they be equipped to every single character? Yes, they can be. So if I go to a character which is like Sharon Rogers. Sharon Rogers has a justice instinct right now, so the justice instinct should be the best suited for this girl. So for this character, for Sharon Rogers, justice will be the preferable artifact that you should equip. Although you can actually equip otherwise as well. You can see I still have the equip option, but don't do this. If you do that, an equipping artifact costs crystals. Okay, so be extra careful. I would say for now at the start, save all the artifact that you have apart from the 1-stars. 1-star are the useless artifacts, and they should be only used for dismantling because they are very easy to get, and I think they will just look at that. Like, what are we actually getting it here? So it's justice increased 10%. It's giving you 5% damage increase towards the pure evil type. Pure evils are actually basically, it's for the world boss legend Null and Mephisto. It will increase your damage by 5%, which is very, very good, but it's a 1-star. I think you could also get a 2-star later on. There is a catch though. You can get a 3-star artifact if that artifact does not have the stat that you want that is useless for you. You cannot change the stats of the artifact. You cannot rank up the artifact. So I have this 1-star. It will stay 1-star for the rest of its life. I cannot make it 2-star no matter what I do. I can enhance it. And you can see I can make it, I can go up to level 20, plus 20. But that will improve the stats on the artifact, but it will not become a 2-star. So why to waste crystals and equipping those things? Plus why to waste materials enhancing these things while they will still be useless because they are just 1-star. And you will probably get a 2-star or 3-star and they will like, okay, it's useless. Yeah, so don't do that. Please. One more thing. After that, you can purchase artifacts, farming artifacts basically, through these chests. So there are a few ways to purchase them. You can use these tokens. Okay. You will get these tokens from various stuff. I think it's in story mode, I believe. So maybe Tamlin Battle. No, sorry. Tamlin Survival. Sorry. We have the artifact chest that you can purchase just like the CDP or the other chest. It can give you a 3-star artifact guaranteed, which is very, very good. So you can actually do this if you want to. Maybe Black Friday, we might actually have this and I might actually go for this one. You know, then what's going on? Then we have advanced artifact quest, the chest here, which you can look, you can see these materials. These are the celestial essence. You get celestial essence from Tamlin Survival and from dismantling your artifact. So if I go here in my inventory right now, if I select my artifacts, I can dismantle them. Each 1-star gives you, you can see 5. Each 1-star gives you 5 of these celestial essence. So you can see I have these one, 8 of them, they will give me 40. So you can actually do this. This is how you farm these things. All right. Next thing is actually the free one that you can get every single day for free. If your VIP is higher, of course, the time will be lesser than 24 days than that. Apart from that, there are these artifact chests that you can actually purchase, at least for now. I think they are daily, I believe so. So I have them purchased already. I'm not sure if they're daily or not, but that's how it goes. The first one is for 100k, that's 1 to 4 star. 250k, 1 to 4 star. The same for 1 to 4 star for 750k gold. And another 1 to 4 star for 1.2 million gold. Now would you say, this is way better than this one because it's still gonna give you 1 to 4 star. Why to purchase everyone? The reason is that they could actually take out the chest, we don't know when. And the more chance that you have to get a higher rank artifact will be better, you know. At least this is a free grinding, so it's just gold. So I think nobody should actually have any issues regarding this thing. And these are the only ways to farm these things right here. Totally free to play. Otherwise, I think I'm not sure if any packs are offering any artifacts or not in the shop. I have not looked at them, but I'll let you guys know if I do find them. Now, after that, which artifact should you be looking for, how to grind them, and which are actually better? So if you go for this chest, you will see a lot of these artifacts here as well, and you will see in the artifact chest as well here. So these are the artifacts that you will be getting. So these are all 4 star that are actually shown here in this one, because it's only gonna give you 1 to 4 star. Although this one, the artifact chest, can actually give you up to 6 stars. And you can see there are characters model. There are character portraits on each artifact. So this artifact, can this be used on every single character? Yes. But this is the juice of this artifact. This is the passive that will only apply to Crescent when you equip to Crescent. Just like this one, if you get the Sharon Rogers artifact, you can use this artifact on any of the characters that you want, but you will only get a random stat out of these. So a lot of stat actually, pure evil, 15% damage. That's 15% is from, of course, for 6 star, not for 1 star. Leadership ability, there is concentration increase, there is decrease pierce damage, that's actually nice for PvP. There is the decrease basic damage received by boss types, that is nice for survivability in game modes like Shadowline sometimes, World Boss Legend, because they are all boss type characters. Actually in Stand on Survival, but I don't think you will actually need that. And then you have this increased critical damage, instant critical damage, increased critical defense, critical rate, and then the instinct dodge and the instinct accuracy. Accuracy probably will be the, the hits, like you get 10 hits and all of those hits, apart from the dodge and everything rate, they will land accurately on your enemy, basically landing the critical hit. I think that's what it means. I will see how, if I can explain that better, but that's all it is. Although there is one thing. I don't understand one freaking thing. Look at this thing. Increases instinct critical damage, decrease by 6%. What the hell is this? This is the only thing that I don't understand among all of these instinct. It increases your instinct critical damage, decrease by 6%. I don't understand this thing. Okay, I'm still trying to if you guys have any idea about this, please let me know in the comment section. I have no idea about this. This is so weird and stupid as well. I think they should take it out. Like, they could not explain that better. So you can see these are going to be very, very nice for certain characters like instant critical rate. I think this is very, very good for Luna Snow and Crescent. Look at this thing. 6 star will give you 20% supervillain damage increase and superhero damage increase. That is so good for ABX and World Boss Legend. For Crescent, okay? For Crescent and Crescent only. Like, supervillain damage, even if you get like 5%, 5% damage increase is very good. Like, we purchase She-Hulk uniform when she get like 60% damage to 65. That's straight 5% that you can probably be getting from maybe 2 star or 3 star, you know. So that's alright. That's very, very good for ABX scores for these characters. Same goes for Luna Snow. And the Luna Snow, actually the very funniest. It increases your cold damage, percentage of your cold resist. You will have to have cold resist on your card. So people having cold resist on your card, like I have 13.5, that is not useless now. You can equip this Luna Snow artifact all Luna Snow and you will be able to get additional cold damage. It will increase your performance for Luna Snow in World Boss Legend as well as your ABX scores as well. So that is pretty awesome. I think the best artifact to get for Sharon Rogers, particularly I would say because it gives you this one, will be the pure evil damage. You can see so that it can actually dish out more damage against the World Boss Legend because that's where the main use of Sharon Rogers is. I'm not sure if the critical damage increase will be better than the 15% damage increase towards the pure evil types, but we will see about that. That will also help out some characters in PvP. I think Wolverine one is also one of the best for PvP. It only applies to Wolverine, but look at that. It basically makes you null. Nullverine, basically. Okay. This is Wolverine with Null's passive. It will probably apply only once in every single fight, but that's huge. Your HP will not drop below 1%. You know, the below the number one. And we know how good Null is because of that. You know, Null survives. So it will actually make your Wolverine very, very good. And I think you should try to get Wolverine one for him particularly because that is going to make Wolverine very, very good and a lot more consistent actually. So I think a lot of these matchups will be depending on the amount of artifact that you have. Plus, the good thing is that the artifacts only apply to these characters for now. And especially the passive, you can give it to any character, but it's mainly gonna be these passives, okay? So it's a way to balancing things out, but I still think that artifacts are gonna be very, very important for every single player. Don't miss out farming these artifacts. I am missing my story mode because I'm making this video right now. I have not done my story mode. You can get the artifacts from story mode, but I heard from people that they tried to play story and they did not actually get a single artifact. It could be a bug because if you play the whole story and you still did not get an artifact, that does not seem right, okay? That still does not seem right because, yeah, you can actually get 1, 2, or 3 star artifacts from here. So, I think that could be a bug or maybe not, but I'll try to see if I can get artifacts later on after the reset when I do so. So, this is actually all about artifacts. No need to worry, no need to panic, or no need to think like 20 times or, you know, scratching your head over these artifacts. They are easy to understand, can be equipped to every single character. The certain ones that we have here, like the icons, you know, the ones with the icons, like these icons, they can be equipped also to any character, but they also give the passive to specific character. So try to get and I try to save all the 2 stars and above artifacts that you can and decide if you do want, even actually 1 star. If you want to save 1 star, you can also save 1 star. I would be, I think, dismantling most of them. I will save the pure evil one because you can actually equip that 1 star. So I can actually go to my Sharon Rogers right now and I can go artifacts and I do have the 1 star. I can equip this one. It has the justice increase. It's also gonna give me 5% extra damage in World Boss Legend. And once I get like higher stars, 2 star, 3 stars, I can just destroy that and equip that one. So I think you can also do that. That's a good way to do that. So I hope this video helped you guys understanding artifacts and everything. They are easy to understand. It will take some time for people to understand, for you guys to understand as well, for me to as well, to get exactly to the place where, you know, right now we know what CTPs do, obelisks do, we know everything about them, we know cards, everything about them. So we will surely know everything about artifact and that stupid thing that actually popped up there and I have no idea about that. I hope so. They also gave a nice explanation about what the hell increase instinct critical damage decreased by 6% means. Okay, I hope they do that. I don't know what's going on. So let me know in the comment section what you think about the video. I hope this video was helpful. And if you do enjoy the content, don't forget to leave a like on the video. It does help me out. And as always, if you do enjoy the content, I hope to see you again. Take care. I'll see you all in the next one. Take care.